Sometimes it's the case where you won't want to evaluate for a given tag, but you want to evaluate for a specific expression and use the data link function as sort of a timer. Here's an example where we have a calculated data function, and they're looking at the maximum of sinusoid for each day over the last 7 days. You can see the start, end time, and intervals. And so let's look at the case where maybe we don't want the max over the entire day, but we want to go back over each of the past 7 days and find the max at a specific range within that day. And here we have a case where we have the expression tag max, sinusoid, and then now minus 8 hours, and now is the start and the end times. And what we're doing with the sample data function is we're evaluating for this expression. We're evaluating the expression every day over the past 7 days at a 24-hour interval. So what we've done is we've gone from using the calculated data function with the max for each day over the last 7 days to using the expression, evaluating that each day for the last 7 days, and the expression result is only the last 8 hours. Let's show you how we might do that in the worksheet. I'll go to PI calculated data, and I'll use the tag CDT158. I'll go back 3 days, and my end time is today, and my time interval will be 1 day, and I want to get an average for that period of time. And you can see the average for each day is shown here in my list. And in fact, why don't we show a timestamp for the start time of that. So let's say I don't want the average for the entire day. I've got an average for 11 September, 12 September, and 13 September. But I want an average for the 8 hours starting at 8 a.m. and ending at 4 p.m. So I've put a expression together, the tag average expression, with tag name CDT158. The starting time is T plus 8H, and the ending time is T plus 16H. And what we'll do is we'll run that expression every day using the sampled data dialog box. So I'll go to sample data, and I'll change to the PI expression. And the expression I'm going to evaluate for is that. My start time is today minus 3 days ago, and my end time is today. My time interval, as in my other expression, is 1 day. And what I get is something that looks very similar. I am evaluating for similar periods, except in the column that I've just shaded in blue, these are the averages only for the 8 hours between 8 a.m. and 4 p.m., whereas the calculated data simply grabs the entire day and gives me an average.